During World War II, both Axis and Allied tanks had hull-mounted machine guns. This weapon is the primary defense against infantry for the tank. It is similar to the machine guns used by infantry, but had a higher magazine capacity and a higher magnification scope for an enhanced line of sight. Despite its superiority in firepower and range, it can only be fired from the frontal side of the tank, making it less versatile. One of the aspects of many World War II tanks is that they needed a fifth crewman who was an assistant driver and radio operator. He was mounted in the front, seated next to the driver, and had the additional duty of using the hull-mounted machine gun as the driver was driving. Assistant driver in many respects means extra person to help with the driver's mechanical work, an extra set of eyes and an extra body in case the driver dies during a combat mission. The situation changed dramatically after the Second World War. As radios improved, the function of the radio operator became less important. Radios became more durable, smaller, and using less electrical power. With certain improvements like better communication that allowed the driver to communicate with those in the turret faster, electrically driven turrets which were more responsive, and better communications removing the need of a separate radio operator, and the acceptance of the more efficient three-man turret with a better reliance on the coaxial machine gun, the limited traverse hull-mounted machine gun was no longer needed, just as the up-armoring and better design eliminated the need for the assistant driver. As long as a radio operator was needed, the hull machine gun was for his use if needed. Once radios no longer needed to be in the hull, the position became extra and thus eliminated mostly by putting the driver in the middle of the tank. This driving position provided more protection for the driver, especially when either set of tracks hit a mine. Thus, the hull machine gun was eliminated, for it was found to be useless, and by eliminating the place, you had more room for ammo and fuel, and made the job of protecting the driver easier. Another issue was that the hull machine gun could only fire where the tank was headed. This restricted where such machine guns could be used on the march. In defense, the practice was to have only the turret exposed to the hull machine gun, ended up aimed at whatever dirt, wall, embankment or anything else the tank was hiding behind. This provided the smallest possible target for the enemy fire. The hull machine gun looked great on film, shooting where the camera is. Thus, on film you see example of the main gun, turret machine gun, the machine gun on the top of the turret, and the hull machine gun firing together as the tank charges into battle. Yes, it looks impressive. But in actual combat, the hull machine gun was too low to be effective or too restricted in movement left to right to hit anything not directly in front of the tank. As to things in front of the tank will run over or push aside anything to its front. Thus, machine gunning those areas first gives the tank no additional advantage. The whole point of the hull gun was the tank could advance with the infantry and make the enemy keep their heads down so they could do so without being massacred like in World War I. When tanks were no longer meant to help infantry to advance, but to attack in armored spearheads, it was no longer needed. It couldn't reach most threats to a tank, like anti-tank guns or other tanks, and created a vulnerable spot. It was expected to have infantry in support, a reverse of what the tanks were supporting the infantry, to help if enemy infantry tried to get in close, and it now had coaxial guns that could be fired on the move and turrets that could traverse a lot faster to cover all angles quickly. After World War II, two things happened. First, the armor requirements had increased immensely during the war. The bowgun created a serious weak point in the main armor, and thus was a problem. The increased armor needs also meant there were less space for an extra crew member. Second, gun stabilization allowed the coaxial machine gun to replace the function of the bow machine gun, i.e. firing on the move. So in summary, it weakens frontal armor, requires an extra crewman to manage, and doesn't have an effective field of fire. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and support my channel on PayPal. Details in the description box.